Hello and welcome to the Vector Garden YouTube channel. In this video, we're going to create a cut path from an image using Illustrator and Photoshop. I've got this image here placed in Illustrator, and although it looks like a vector artwork, this is a pixel artwork. And of course, you might run into this issue when plotting your artworks that you have downloaded from a clip art website. And sometimes they come as pixel images. So, and you want to create the cut line from them. So this artwork is not transparent. It has a white background. Now, how do we go about it? We can use Illustrator, but in this case, we're going to use Photoshop for tracing this outline. So I'm going to switch to Photoshop. There it is. And in order to select this, we're going to take the magic wand tool, which is here. And you see it's in a group with the object selection tool. So you select the magic wand tool and then set it up. In this case, I've set the tolerance to 0 because this background is really white everywhere. You turn on anti-aliasing and you check off contiguous. So this will also trace the white in here and any other white that is separated from the rest. So just click in here and we've got the selection. And of course, we need to invert this selection. So there's a shortcut for it, but you can also find it here and make the inverse like so. Next thing is we need a path because we want to have this in Illustrator. So you can go to the paths panel, which is often in a group with layers and channels, and you can also select it from window and there is paths. And in here, you can go into the menu, make a work path. And the work path comes with a tolerance. So usually this is set to 2, and the lower the value you set, the more precise is this. So you have to try it out and see if it's precise enough for your purposes. So I'm going to leave it with 2. And then let's see here. And you see this is what results from it. So we want to make a cut path, and for that, those detailed things aren't really good anyway. So I'm going to leave it here. But if you need that precision, it's worth trying it out, entering a lower value, and then go with that. So let's leave it here. Next thing we need to do is double click this path, make it a named path, and then go in here and make this into a clipping path, like so. And then, of course, save the file. So we're going to save as, and then save this in the file in the folder that we've set up. And I'm going to save this as a Photoshop file. You can also save it as a JPEG, because then the clipping path will be inside. But Photoshop is not compressed, so let's go with that. And save this like so. Then we need to go back to Illustrator and let's get rid of this and go to File, Place, and place the Photoshop file like so. Now, when using this in Illustrator, it's important that you set up a document color mode in RGB or CMYK. And you need to get the information beforehand in which one of these you need it, because we need to embed this image in Illustrator in order to get at this path. And when embedding the image, it will be converted into the document color space. And therefore, you need to do it the way you need it. So we're going to place it like so. And you see it's now linked. So you see that from the cross. So let's embed it. And then we have this image. And let's go to the layers panel and see what we've got. And you see here, there is the clipping path. And then we can go to object, clipping mask, and release it like so. There we have the path. And Let's select it. And you see it's a compound shape. That would be better to release as well, because maybe your device can't handle that. Let's go to Window Pathfinder and expand it. And then we've got a compound path instead, like so. Let's make that visible. I'm going to give it a color. And you see it runs around the image. And this can get an issue when you go in here and you see all these kinds of thing. So when they are cut, then maybe it won't work. So these are two tiny details. And maybe they can get cut, but then when you use the sticker, then you lose all of these and they tear off and wear off on the sticker. So this is not desirable. So what you need to do with that is it needs to follow around like so and enclose these details in a more wider fashion. So how do we get that? For this, you go to Object Path and then Offset Path. And of course, you need to select this first. So let's select it and go to Object Path and then Offset Path. And you see, this offsets it. Nice. And of course, we need to make this round so we get nice round edges. And you can define the offset. And you see, maybe you need just a little offset, but this still gives you these bulges. And maybe you don't want them. You want that more loosely there and tighter in there. So we can deal with that. So first of all, we make it really, really white. And you see, all of this is now really nice, like so. And this is not so nice. So we need to make it a little tinier, like so. So we need this in here. That is okay. And like so. But this is too far away. So how do we deal with that? Doesn't matter. We leave it like so. And then we can apply another one. Object, path, offset path. And then you enter a negative value. And you see, you get the nice loose fitting there and it's tighter in here. And also for the legs, that is quite nice, like so. And again, take care that this is rounded. Okay. Now what you have seen, the offset path function always makes copies. This is, of course, not desirable. I have to delete them afterwards. I just left them in here so we can check out again what we got. So first of all, we had this tight one and then we made this loose one and then we made this slightly tighter again and got what we wanted, like so. So we can later select this and select this one and delete it. And there we have our path. So this is how you can go there. You can also apply offset path as an effect. There is the offset path effect. The next thing that you still need to do, you need to check out what you need to send to your plotter. So this is now colored in cyan. So maybe you need to set up a spot color and maybe you need to set up a specific point size, point weight of the stroke, and maybe you needed to give it a name. These things, these specifications are different for every device. So check that out and then make it as needed. So that's how you create your cut line in Photoshop and adjust it and edit it in Illustrator.